we're going to look at Google Earth Pro and how we use that as part of the EAMENA project. Now, hopefully, the basic controls of Google Earth Pro are well known to all users at the present. We're going to give you a few tips and introduce you to the grid system that we use and how to create a folder to record data for the EAMENA database. So here's a view of the EAMENA region as a whole. A useful key to use throughout the operation is R, which will rectify everything to a north-facing perspective. So I click R, and it just rotates the screen slightly. But anything we do, for instance, if we hold Shift and scroll and drag the screen to an oblique angle, just press R again, and it'll correct. Another useful tool is Backspace, for if you've scrolled away from something and you want to return to that position and can't find it otherwise, just click Backspace, and it will return for a short space in your last drag to where you were. So as part of using Google Earth Pro, you should hopefully have the EAMENA full grid KMZ. So the EAMENA project divides up the whole of the EAMENA region into grids. So if we click on it just momentarily, it's a very large file, so it will slow everything down. You can see the whole area is covered with grid squares of 0.25 of a degree, a decimal degree that is, and these are about 25 kilometers square each, turning them off. And within that folder, we also have various countries broken into either individual countries or groups, for instance, Morocco. And because of the way these have been built, they actually go beyond the borders of Morocco. But it's just this grids covering the country that will be relevant for any recording in Morocco. Again, in Egypt, grids covering the whole of the country. And if we zoom in and press R again, you can see the size of each one of these grids. If we click the grid on again and click on an individual grid, and it'll give you the number, which is E28 North 26 22. The E28 and North 26 relate to the latitude and longitude in the bottom corner. So to find a site that you're looking for, you can either navigate directly, if you know where the exact site location is, or you can type latitude and longitude coordinates into the search bar, or in some cases, with well-known place names, you might be able to search the place name itself. So for instance, in Egypt, we can look for the Giza Pyramid Complex and click search, and Google Earth will take us directly to the site. Now what we can do here is select to find out what grid that we'll be using for this area. So East 31, North 29, 33. So when we're creating data in the EAMENA database, we generally create a folder in which to store all the data. And when you click Add and Folder, you should come up with the following screen. And generally, we will give the folder the same name as the grid square that we're working in. We see the creation in the left-hand bar of my places, the name of the grid. From then, we can start collecting data. We can either do this as a pin, for instance, here on the pyramid itself. And if we want, we can change the form of our pin by clicking in the top right. We can change the color and scale, but also the type and shape. And we will give the feature a code, which is the grid square, followed by an underscore, it's also possible to create a polygon in this point. Again, if we were recording the same way, so this will be number two. I shouldn't have actually closed that there. If I go back to Get Info to edit a record I've made, I select it on the left-hand side. move this aside, and much like in the Polygon form of the ايمينا database, create this. Obviously, that's not particularly helpful. But we can go to style and color and change that just to outlined. So it gives you the full circumference of the site. Now, when we filled a grid, and often we will follow surveying a grid, we will look at it systematically. And we will start and use the grid system, moving up and down, or side to side across the grid, until we've investigated the whole area. Once we've finished our grid, we can save by right-clicking on the folder, saving my places, and recording it, usually as a KML, because that's most appropriate for them moving into the ايمينا database. As you're recording, it's very careful that if you click on the screen while the grid squares are active, that you make sure that on your folder on the left-hand side that you return to your grid pins. Otherwise, if you try and create a pin after you've clicked on the screen, your data will go into that folder as opposed to the folder you've created for that grid. A really important tool when using Google Earth Pro is the time slider. This is a way of moving through all the different satellite imagery data with an estimate of the date that it was captured currently on Google Earth. Here, because you're in a center of population and a well-known site around the pyramids of Giza, there is a lot of data. In some areas, you may only have single sheets of data. Moving closer, we'll see transformations. Often nothing will have changed in between these images, but sometimes we'll see site damage, and we can record that as part of our condition assessment. So this is how we use Google Earth Pro. Obviously, there are other tutorials available. But this is the basic way in which we will use it. And it's from this that we can add data into the ايمينا database.